Sheriff's Department like to report that at between 1 and 1:30, the victim took his life after the situation. And, you know, it's a tragic ending. And we feel like that, you know, we want to let the family know that it was really something that couldn't have been helped in their part. The situation happens when you're on drugs, and you know, he wasn't thinking right. And we made all the attempts in the world to try to let this guy have a chance to come out and make it a peaceful ending. But that's what I can report here.
And to your neighbors, constituents that live around here, do you want them to know anything? Some of them are concerned, you know, that maybe the meth thing might be a problem. Is that something you're definitely aware of?
Yes, we're all aware of the meth problems that's within the United States and, you know, on all the borders. We really are trying our best to try to deter that. But, you know, when somebody makes the choice, it's not that it's forced upon them. It's your choice that you make that decision whether you want to be involved with that type of life. And, you know, this guy here, he made that choice. You know, he was a violent type guy. And, you know, that was basically nobody's fault but his own. And that's where we got to look at is that people in society needs to realize we make the choice. It's nobody else that makes it.
And Sheriff, you know, earlier he was making statements that he wanted to kill himself in front of your deputies. You know, is this something that you'd consider suicide by police, trying to get officers to kill him or something? Or is that only if you're shot by an officer?
Basically, that comes through our minds, and, you know, that happens. And we prepared ourselves for that. We're trained for that. And the thing is that we decided that this was a situation which could have been a dangerous situation toward the officers themselves. But they would have been aware of what happened. And we don't want to have a bad ending on anything. You know, we're here to protect. We're here to help. We're not here to go after somebody because we don't like them. We like everybody in our county. We like everybody in the state. All law enforcement, that's what we're here for, is to help. And, you know, when somebody does something wrong or whatever, we just want to help them and try to get them on the right track.
You said that you guys did everything in your power to try and make this peaceful. Could you kind of talk about some of the stuff that went on over the course of, you know, the night into this morning before this obviously did end in this individual taking his life, but some of the things that you were trying to do to make this a peaceful ending?
We talked to him, and we were basically in contact with him when our department got there and talked to him. You know, you can only make so much, you know, to try to talk to somebody if they're in the right mind. Apparently, he's been on this, been doing this for some time now. He's made the choice. You know, we can only do what we can. This morning it happened, and it's you know, it was lucky that the two people in the house wasn't injured or injured more severely, even the girlfriend herself. It's just it's unfortunate that it happens, but it happens, you know, it's not just located in this one spot. It happens everywhere.
And no injuries to any law enforcement personnel or anyone responding?
None at all.
None at all.
And we did see just some what looked like smoke coming up. Was that maybe gas? There were no flames, right, at any point?
It was gas, yes. And, you know, Luke, the captain here can talk about that part of it.
Okay. Thank you. Anything else that you want to add, Sheriff?
Just that it's a tragic ending, and we wish the best for that family, and that the family realize that all of our hopes and prayers are with them. And we are very, very concerned and hope that it works out for them.